Good afternoon, students. How are you? Let's welcome to another session. My name is B. Revati, working as Biological Science, KGBV, PTM. Okay, I am going to revision 10th class 2020-21 batch. In this session, I am going to discuss about coordination in the life process. In this lesson, first of all, you know, we discuss about introduction. Okay. Human body is a wonderful machine. It is a complicated structure that then it appears. Human body involved in different life process like digestion, respiration, excretion, circulation and also reproduction. For this specific place is there in our body to perform specific functions. These functions, these life process alone cannot perform functions. For that there should be coordination between them. In this chapter we will discuss about how different systems coordinate each other, mainly digestion and its relation or coordination with other systems. What are life process, survival and proportions of the organism is called life process. Okay, digestion, respiration, excretion, transportation and reproduction are example of this life process. Before discussing this lesson, we have to recall structure of digestion system. Structure of digestive system. The length of the digestive system is approximately 9 meters. It is a tube-like structure. It has various parts for various substances. Digestion, first part, mouth. This digestion, first part is the mouth. Mouth is the first part of digestive system. It contains teeth, tongue and different muscles and also salivary glands. Okay. What contains in the mouth? The mouth contains teeth, tongue and different muscles and also mouth helps in mastication of food. Here, saliva plays critical role in digestion. Saliva plays critical role in digestion of carbohydrates, proteins, digestion of food, bolus may be formed. Okay, next part is oesophagus. Next to pharynx. Pharynx, it is common passage for food and air. Bolus may enter into pharynx from here to food into next part. Next part is oesophagus. Here, peristalsis helps for the food transportation. Next part is stomach. From oesophagus, food enter into stomach is a by like structure. Here, partial digestion of proteins happens with the help of acids. Here, chyme may form. Next, another part is small intestine. Chyme enter into small intestine from stomach via duodenum. Small intestine is a coil structure. Complete digestion takes place here. Complete digestion takes place in small intestine. Next, large intestine. Completely digested food enter into small intestine and undigested food enter into large intestine. Here, water and essential substance reabsorbed. then understand food sent into colon through anus it may send out. Now come back to lesson first on the topic feeling hungry. If you want to do any work, energy is required. Energy gained from food. Now we have to discuss about activity to know about feeling hungry. Smell of food, taste of food, sight of food, hearing, excited, need of food, and thought of food may encourage feel of hunger. A major cause for feeling hungry lies in the physiology of blood circulation level. Levels of different substances are generally maintained in the blood, mainly by our digestive system. When the levels of sugar fall in the blood, we get hunger pangs in the stomach. When sugar level fall, the walls of stomach release hormone called ghrelin. Which is creates hunger contractions. Which hormone is responsible for hunger pangs? Ghrelin. Okay, ghrelin is the hormone is responsible for hunger pangs. Along with ghrelin, diencephalon of forebrain and vagus nerve. 10 pineal nerve. Along with the ghrelin, diencephalon of the forebrain and vagus nerve, 10 pineal nerve plays an important role in carrying these signals to the brain. Hunger pangs continue up to 30 to 45 minutes only. Hunger pangs continue up to 30 to 45 minutes only. Which part of the forebrain carries information about of hunger to brain? Diencephalon. Okay. What is the duration of hunger pangs? 30 to 45 minutes. What is the under name of 10th cranial nerve? Vagus nerve. Very important. These three bits half mark or 1 mark. Okay. What is the under name of 10th cranial nerve? Vagus nerve. Ghrelin motivates to consume when we feel our stomach is full and there is no need of food. Ghrelin motivates to consume when we feel our stomach is full and there is no need of food. Okay, another hormone secreted by the walls of digestive system called leptin. Next, another hormone secreted by the walls of digestive system called leptin. Suppress hunger. Okay, it suppress hunger. Which hormone suppress to consume food? Leptin. Which hormone suppress to consume food? Leptin. Okay. Next, another topic is taste and smell are closely related. Now we will discuss about taste and smell are closely related. Taste and smell are interrelated, always both are dependent on each other. If we are suffering from cough and cold, we can't identify the taste of the food. Why? Because receptors in nerves are connected with taste buds to identify taste. So if we are suffering from cold and cough, we can't differentiate the taste of the different food items. Okay. Next, taste is something connected to the tongue and palate. Taste is something connected to the tongue and palate. Let us do a simple activity to see the role of different parts of the mouth in helping us to taste. Okay. Sugar crystal over the tongue. Place some sugar crystals on your mouth. Keep your mouth open and see that your tongue does not tip the palate recorded. The time till you got the taste by using stopwatch. Now, sugar crystal over the tongue. Place some sugar crystals on your mouth. Keep your mouth open and see that your tongue does not touch the palate. Record the time till you got the taste by using stopwatch. Okay. Now, repeat the activity by keeping sugar crystals on the tongue. Now, press the tongue against the palate. Record the time till you getting the taste by using the stopwatch. In the second situation, we touch tongue against palate. That's why sugar molecules enter into taste buds. Okay. As a result, we can sense the taste of food and triggering taste signals reaches to brain. And we can exactly taste the food. Okay. Next, another topic is mouth, the munching machine. When we eat food, that may reaches to mouth and broken down into simple substance by the help of teeth, tongue and some muscles of walls as saliva. As a result, carbohydrates partially digest here. Next, cutting and crushing of food in mouth is called mastication. What is mastication? Cutting and crushing of food in mouth is called mastication. Bolus may be formed by mastication of food in our mouth. Next, circular muscles of the mouth push food into oral cavity and to be moved around for the mastication. After mastication, food becomes smooth and enter into next part. From the mouth by swallowing, fifth cranial nerve responsible for movement of jaw muscles, which mastication happens in a mouth. What is mastication? Cutting and crushing of the food in the mouth is called mastication. It is by the help of teeth, tongue and other muscles. Okay. What happens to the food? Suppose did not mastication in the mouth, carbohydrates may not partially digested. So it is difficult to dissipate all of food materials in digestive system. Which cranial nerve responsible for jaw muscles movement? Fifth cranial nerve. Which cranial nerve responsible for jaw muscles movement? Fifth cranial nerve. Okay. Saliva secretion under the action of autonomous nervous system. Saliva secretion under the action of autonomous nervous system. This system stimulate to secrete saliva from three pairs of salivary glands while we consume food. Saliva helps in bolus formation and make the food moist and soft to move from one part to another. Okay, saliva helps in bolus formation and make the food moist and soft to move from one part to another. Okay, how bolus forms? After mastication, there may be formation of soft bar of food that is called bolus. Okay, for next, another topic is dentition. An adult human has 32 teeth. There are 4 types of teeth in human beings. There are 4 types of teeth in human beings. First one, incisors. These are 8 biting the food to make small pieces. Second one, canines. 4 paring or tearing the food. Third one, premolars. 8 molars, 12. These premolars, molars, grinding the food materials. Next, dental formula. 2 by 2, 1 by 1, 2 by 2, 3 by 3. Next, we will discuss about the activity. Action of tylene on starch. Action of tylene on starch. First, aim to show the action of tylene, salivary enzyme on starch. Apparatus: test tube, saliva, starch powder, iodine, paraffin. Test tube, saliva, starch powder, iodine, paraffin. Next, procedure: collect saliva into a test tube and filter it. Take 10 ml of starch solution into a test tube. Add 2 drops of iodine solution to it. Starch solution changes into blue black color. Then divide it into 2 parts in 2 test tubes. Add 5 ml of saliva into first part. Do not add anything into the second part. Keep these test tubes in a test tube stand and observe. What are the procedure? Collect saliva into a test tube and filter it. Take 100 ml of starch solution into a test tube. Add 2 drops of iodine solution to it. Starch solution changes into blue black color. Then divide it into 2 parts in 2 test tubes. Add 5 ml of saliva into a first part. Do not add anything into the second part. Keep these test tubes in a test tube stand and observe. Next, observation. We will not find any color change in the test tube to which water is added. We will find the color change in the test tube to which saliva is added. We will not find any color change in the test tube to which water is added. We will find the color change in the test tube to which saliva is added. Next, inference. This experiment shows the action of saliva on starch. Next, precautions. Clean your mouth before collecting saliva. Carefully handle the glass waste. Okay, these are precautions. What are the precautions? Clean your mouth before collecting saliva. Carefully handle the glass vase. Okay. For the bolus formation, saliva helps. Okay. Saliva secretion depends on which nerve system? Saliva secretion depends on which nerve system? Autonomous nervous system. Autonomous nervous system. After mastication, food swallowed and pushes into next part. For the swallowing mechanism, medulla oblongata and nervous system helps this. Okay. Next, why do we salivate during a nap of daytime? Because we are so our digestive system active at daytime and inactive at night time. When we sleep daytime, due to active condition of our system, we may wet the pillow. Diurnal animals means the animal. Diurnal means the animal which contains active functions at daytime. Nocturnals are the animals which contains active functions at night time. Examples are bats. Human secrete 1 to 1.5 liters per day. Human secrete the saliva 1 to 1.5 liters per day. How many liters of saliva secrete by human? 1 to 1.5 liters per day. Now we will discuss about lab activity which tells the role of acids. Okay. This process take two similar green leaves. Grease one leaf with petroleum jelly. Leave the other free now. Next on the topic is travel of food through oesophagus. The oesophagus receives food from the swallowing actions of the mouth. When the food is present in the oral cavity, the nerves present in the cheek and tongue get stimulated and send messages to brain in the form of nervous impulse. These in turn get transmitted to the wall of stomach and stimulate the gastric glands to produce gastric juice. The walls of the stomach secrete juices containing hydrochloric acid stimulated by nervous impulse. When the muscles of stomach contract, the food gets mixed with the acids and juices present in stomach. These digestive juice convert the food into a smooth chop-like texture called chyme. As the process comes to an end, the contractions of the stomach decreases. This relaxes the muscles called this in turn opens the pathway into duodenum by releasing the pathway digested food chyme in small quantities into the duodenum. This process helps in forward movement of food. We know that the digestion of food starts from mouth and passes through the gut. In order to digest the food satisfy of some time at the different locations. The table on the
given. Our stomach looks like a pouch, which is elastic in nature because size of stomach increases depending upon the food which we eat. The food leaving the stomach will be in the form of soup like mixture. This mixture passes into small intestine. When the food enters the small intestine, the acidic nature of chyme secretes different hormones like secretion and the inner surface of small intestine consists of thousands of finger-like projections termed as villi. Villi absorb the nutrients in a selective manner because the walls of intestine allows only tiny nutrient particles to pass through the leaves. The large proteins particles inside. Among all the internal organs, digestive tract plays an important role as it is exposed to a large variety of stimuli in the form of ingested food. The digestive tract consists of both the muscular and neural approaches. They ensure the appropriate mixing of contents during digestion, absorption, and excretion. The neural apparatus, which consist of vast and complicated network of neurons, it is named as second brain by the scientist. The neural apparatus, which consists of vast and complicated network of neurons, is named as second brain by the scientist. The gut present in immune system protects our body from harmful diseases. The neurons, second brain, help the gut cell to kill the bacteria which enters our body. The second brain consists of some 100 million nerves. This is more than the nerves present in spinal cord or peripheral nervous system. These neurons in the second brain are embedded in the walls of long tube of our gut or alimentary canal. This is about 9 meters long, extending from esophagus to anus. The second brain controls several functions of the gut without the influence of the main brain, such as stimulating and coordinate pathways which expel waste from our body are shown in the screen.
Take two similar green leaves. Grease one leaf with petroleum jelly. Leave the other free. Now add one or two drops of some weak of acid on both the leaves. Observe weak of acids. Observe them after half an hour. Observe them half an hour. We can observe that there is no role of acid on the leaf which applied by petroleum jelly. But under one turn into pale because of acid in the same way in our stomach, same way in our stomach muscles membrane to protect cells from the strong acid HCl. Which acid released by cells of the stomach walls? Which acid released by cells of the stomach wall? HCl. We will do an activity for Willy. Take 10 into 20 centimeter size chart paper. Fold the chart paper and join both ends with gum to make a cube. Okay. Now take another chart paper size of 20 into 20 centimeters and make a tube. Yeah, mention the same about try to insert the big tube in a small one. Try to insert the big tube in a small one. Can you? It is not possible. Okay. Now join both ends to make a folded paper tube. Try to insert folded tubes in first tube. Can we? How it is possible? Okay. The inner surface of the small intestine contains thousands of finger-like projections called villi. What is the relation between finger-like structure and paper folds? These are relation between finger-like projections and paper folds. These villi increase the surface area so that the food retained in the folds can remain larger.
The structure of villi. Villi, the finger-like projections present in the inner walls of the small intestine are called villi. Finger-like projections present in the inner walls of the small intestine are called villi. Blood vessels and lymph vessels are present to form a network in villi. They absorb the digested food into the blood. Due to the presence of villi, surface of the small intestine increase. It helps rapid absorption of digestive food materials. Okay. Finger-like projections presence in the inner walls of the small intestine are called villi. Blood vessels and lymph vessels are present to form a network in villi. They absorb the digested food into the blood. Due to the presence of villi, surface of the small intestine increase. It helps rapid absorption of digestive food materials.
What is villi? The finger-like structures on the surface of small intestine walls are called villi. This is important for off marker 1 mark bit. What is villi? The finger-like structures on the surface of small intestinal walls are called villi. Next one, what is the function of villi? Villi increase the surface area of the digestion and it helps in absorption of food. Okay, what is function of villi? This is also important. Villi increase the surface area of the digestion. Villi is increase the surface area of the digestion and it helps in absorption of food. What is absorption? Conversion of food from digestive system to circulatory system is called absorption. What system do you think are working together here? Digestive system, circulatory system and nervous system. Okay. How can you justify the enteric nervous system as second brain of the gut? The digestive tract enacts among interorgans because it is exposed to a large variety of stimuli from the external world. In the form injected food, so intestine has developed a rich coordinated muscular and neural apparatus. It helps the mixing and propelling of contents during digestion, absorption and excretion. Next, scientists are calling the second brain because 70% of immune system depend on digestive system to expire or kill foreign germs. It contains a vast number of nerves which communicate between gut and brain. It contains vast number of nerves which communicate between gut and brain. Second brain contains 100 million nerves. 100 million of nerves or neurons. More than in either spinal cord or peripheral nervous system. It doesn't much more than merely heart digestion process. The little brain do much more than the main brain. It determined the mental state and plays a key role in certain diseases thought of throughout the body. Okay, so we can justify the enteric nervous system as the second brain of the gut. Okay. Next, the other topic is the sphincter muscles of the food canal. The circular muscles fibers at the opening of the stomach form a strong bond which serves to keep it closed. Such circular muscles are called sphincters. What is sphincters? Sphincters, the circular muscular fibers at the opening of the stomach form a strong bond which serves to keep it closed. Such circular muscles are called sphincters. In digestive tract, there are two such sphincters. One is phyloric sphincter and the anal sphincters. First one, phyloric sphincters. In case of the stomach, it is known as phyloric sphincters. These sphincters remains at the first firmly closed during digestion. When this sphincter opens, small amount of chyme is fused into duodenum, simultaneously forcing moist food back into stomach. Next, another part is anal sphincters. There are two muscular layers helping in exit stools. There are two muscular layers helping in exit stools. One is the under involuntary control, whereas the other is under voluntary control. Both of them help in opening and closing the operator, which are called anal sphincters. Okay, both of them help in opening and closing the operation, which are called anal sphincter. During respiration, we breathe continuously by inhaling and exhaling air. This is an involuntary process controlled by the medulla oblongata of the autonomous nervous system. Okay.
Next, assignment. What are the difference between bolus and chyme? What are the difference between bolus and chyme? Second one, what are the difference between mastication and rumination? Next, third question, What is mastication? Explain the role of different set of teeth in this process. Next, fourth one. How can you justify the enteric nerve system as the second brain of the gut? Next, fifth question. What experiment should you perform to understand the action of saliva on floor? Explain its procedure and apparatus that you followed. Next one. Draw a schematic diagram of Willis in small intestine. Explain how digestive system coordinate with the circulatory system. Next one. What happens if salivary ducts are closed? Next one. What pathways connected to sensation of taste does the diagram show?